So today, we're gonna go through how to dominate the ball in the air. My name is Tuukka Salan. I'm a former professional football player. I'm here to help you on your journey.
Do not scratch your eyes! You are really seeing the most extraordinary finish here! It almost mirrors the final...
Controlling the ball in the air might be very intimidating in the beginning, but if you follow a few simple principles, it will get easier and easier. Number one. Don't let the ball hit the ground. If you let the ball hit the ground, you will automatically play slower tempo and you will give the defender a chance to win the ball. Number two, take it down with the closest possible body part, chest, thigh or foot. This principle allows you to play the quickest possible way and now you don't have to worry about are you playing with the stronger or weaker side. In this case, it would be your left or right foot. Number three, the particular body part behind the ball. This will help with the shielding the ball after the first touch, or if the first touch is not perfect, it doesn't slip away because it hits your body. Number four, take it down at the highest possible point. This will make you look faster on the field because you're always first to the ball and you're beating defenders left, right and center just because you're first to the ball, not because you're faster. Basic technique. Arch your back, arms up, elbows wide. Bend your knees and cushion it down like a raw egg. Let's put it this way. If somebody throws you a raw egg, how are you gonna catch it? Are you gonna cushion it or just let it hit hard on your hands and now the egg breaks, it's on the kitchen floor and your mom is very upset. If you have a partner, keepy-ups are always a good way to learn how to do a better first touch. Or just play long balls back and forth, different directions, different angles, different distances. This is a very good way to learn how to take the ball down in the air in generally. If you don't have a partner, you can just do keepy-ups with the chest high foot. This also is really good warm-up before the games. This type of warm-up makes you really loosen up, helps your agility, coordination, and really become friends with the ball. Using the wall as your training partner is one of my biggest favorites because it gives you pass back exactly how you play it to it. So if you give it a bad pass, it responds with the bad pass. So you better make sure that you give him a good pass to receive a good pass. If you're getting a bad back pass from the wall, who are you gonna blame? Are you gonna blame the wall or yourself? This is a good way to reflect how good is your first touch and a pass. Here's a perfect example of many mistakes and not giving up, just reflecting on your mistakes and make it better next time. Looks like I got it. Thank you for watching. See you next time.